there was a great development of Gupta art and architecture. There was an art and architecture developed and flourished under the Gupta period. It's because of this reason, one important reason. You know, you will often see the term that golden age, golden age, golden age. The Gupta period is known as the golden age because of this important reason that there was a great development of art and literature. Besides the other reasons which are seen to be the reasons responsible for the term that Gupta age is referred to as the golden age in Indian history, this reason, the development of art and literature which we have seen during the Gupta period is also responsible for this thing. Okay, now we will study these topics separately. First we will deal with art, then we will study about the literature. About the art and architecture under the Guptas, it was the development of Nagara style of temple architecture. Now remember, there are three styles of temple architectures in India. One is the Nagara style of temple architecture, which you can say northern, the temple architecture which prevailed over the northern India is known as the Nagara style of temple architecture. The temple architecture which prevailed over the southern India, that is known as the Dravidian style of architecture. Dravidian style of architecture. Okay, Dravidian style, it prevailed over the southern India. Jab hum later on Pallava architecture padhenge and the architecture like those of the Cholas, that is marked by this feature. Wahan pe hum Dravidian temple architecture bolte hai, us temple architecture jo south India mein prevalent hota hai. So, but there is one more style of temple architecture. That is the region which lies between the northern and the southern India. The region which lies between the northern and southern India, that is central India mein jo temple architecture prevalent hota hai, usko bolte hai Visara style. Visara style of temple architecture. Visara style of temple architecture is that architecture which was prevalent over the central India. It had both the features of the Dravidian style as well as the features of the Nagara style. Now, it was mainly the Nagara style of temple architecture which developed over India during the Guptas, under the Guptas. Because as I told you that Guptas ruled over the northern India, their contemporaries were the Vakatagas and other minor dynasties. They no doubt were subjugated by the Samudragupta, but somehow they could manage to, you know, they could, they were able to manage their own affairs. So this Nagara style of architecture, ko aapko samajhna hai, what were the features of this Nagara style of temple architecture? This Nagara style of temple architecture was marked by various features. Like the temple which was, you know, first remember this thing that it was under the Gupta age only to begin with that the temple architecture was perfected in India. The construction of temples on a large scale, on those lines which we see during the present times, what temples jo jisme hame aajkal bhi features dekhte hain, jaise aajkal ke types ke temples hame milte hain all over the country, that style of temple in the North India was initiated by the Guptas. That style is known as the Nagara style of temple architecture. This Nagara style, iske features bahut zyada the. For example, there was a platform made up of bricks or stones, and upon that platform a building was established. Like, first of all, there was a huge platform which was constructed of the bricks or the stones, and on this platform, then you had the main building which was established there. It was a temple. Okay, so this platform upon which the temple was constructed was the feature of this Nagara style of architecture, temple architecture. Then there was another feature what is known as Panchayatan style. Panchayatan feature. Panchayatan means that Panchayatan, you can, you know, see the name, it denotes five. Panchayat, that means there were five shrines. There were four subsidiary shrines like this one. There were five subsidiary and smaller shrines which were enclosing the main shrine, which was enclosing the main important shrine. So a single temple nahi tha. This was an enclosure. वहां पे बहुत सारे चार पांच बिल्डिंग्स, टेंपल बिल्डिंग्स होती थी. जो मेन टेंपल होता था वो सेंटर में होता था, एंड इट वाज एनक्लोज्ड बाय द वेरियस अदर सब्सिडियरी टेंपल्स एंड द श्राइन्स. दैट फीचर इज नोन एज द पंचायत स्टाइल. ओके, देन अदर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ दिस नगारा स्टाइल ऑफ टेंपल आर्किटेक्चर इज दैट व्हाट इज नोन एज प्रेजेंस ऑफ शिखर. जब आपने टेम्पल तो देखा ही होगा सबने, इस टेम्पल के ऊपर जो एक टावर जैसा होता है, ऐसा स्ट्रक्चर होता है टावर जैसा. मैं कोई अच्छा पेंटर नहीं हूं, तो इसके ऊपर जो एक यू नो दिस एक टावर जैसा स्ट्रक्चर होता है टेम्पल के ऊपर, तो उसको हम शिखर बोलते हैं. तो ये शिखर भी हमें गुप्ता टेम्पल्स में मिलता है. दैट शिखर इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ दिस नगारा स्टाइल ऑफ टेम्पल आर्किटेक्चर. और फिर इस शिखर के ऊपर एक ऐसा एक स्मॉल सा स्ट्रक्चर होता है, उसको हम कलश बोलते हैं. कलश, तो इस कलश जो है, दिस कलश अलोंग विद यू नो दिस दिस शिखर, दिस वाई द इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर्स ऑफ दिस नगारा स्टाइल ऑफ टेंपल आर्किटेक्चर. ओके, ग्रेट केयर वाज गिवन टू व्हाट, टू द गर्भागृह. Garbhagraha is a place where the main idol is placed. If there is a temple of Vishnu or a temple of Shiva, so that idol is placed at a particular, you know, particular sacred place. That area is known as the Garbhagraha, where actually the main idol is placed. That place is known as Garbhagraha. So this care was given for its decoration, you know, for its proper placement, where to place this idol, and that was, you know, beautified. So that place is known as Garbhagraha. So care was given to this thing. Okay, then another important feature of this Nagara style, you can say, was the presence of mandaps. What is mandap? Mandap literally means, mandap means assembly hall. Now mandap or the assembly hall, it was the place where the people used to assemble for prayers, where they used to sit for prayers. It was a multi-pillared hall which was placed right opposite to the main idol, right opposite to the Garbhagraha. Okay, so you have to remember this feature as well. As far, these were the important features of Nagara style of architecture. What is the difference between Nagara and the Dravidian style of architecture? जब मैं आपको पल्लवा और this Chola का art पढ़ाऊंगा, उस वक्त आपको differentiate clear हो जाएगा. You know, like in the southern Indian temple architecture, you will find the great enclosing walls. वहाँ पे बहुत बड़े-बड़े walls, boundary walls होते हैं. यहाँ पे ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. गोपुराम आप वहाँ पे देखोगे, यहाँ पे गोपुराम का feature नहीं है. अब वो क्या होता है, वो मैं आपको detail में पढ़ाऊंगा when I will go through the पल्लवा and this Chola type of architecture. और राष्ट्रकूटास का भी थोड़ा इसमें मिलता जुलता है, तो वो मैं आपको तब के लिए रेफर कर दूंगा. लाइकवाइज यू नो प्रेजेंस ऑफ वाटर टैंक्स वहां पे बहुत अच्छा इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर है साउथ इंडियन टेंपल्स में. यहाँ पे वाटर टैंक्स का फीचर नहीं मिलता है. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ फीचर्स विल डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द नगारा एंड दिस यू नो दिस नगारा एंड द द्रविड़ियन स्टाइल ऑफ टेंपल आर्किटेक्चर. नाउ सी दिस फीचर्स, यू नो गुप्तास दे एस्टैब्लिश्ड वेरियस टेंपल्स, लार्ज नंबर ऑफ टेंपल्स एट डिफरेंट प्लेस इन नॉर्दर्न इंडिया. I can give you an example where these features have been, you know, these features have been actually found. There were temples like, you know, we have one temple at Tigawa. We have one temple at Tigawa. Tigawa is a temple, you know, in Madhya Pradesh. Tigawa is a place in Madhya Pradesh. This temple was dedicated to Shiva. At this place, we have this feature. As what I told you in the Nagara features, यहाँ पे हमें मिला है Tigawa in Madhya Pradesh, the temple. Remember, you know this, there were various deities, there were various gods which were worshipped during the Gupta times. In northern India, the god which was worshipped was Vishnu. In southern India, it was Shiva, and in eastern India, it was Shakti. Shakti worship was going on there. You know, the main god which was worshipped. In that area, that part of the country, and different gods, different temples were dedicated to these gods. So naturally, this was mainly, you know, the temple, you know, this, it's not Vishnu actually, it's not Shiva, it's Vishnu. The temple which was established at Tigawa in Madhya Pradesh, it was dedicated to Vishnu. Likewise, we have various other temples, like we have the temple in Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, we have the temple, UP. That temple is known as Dishavatar temple, right? Dishavatar temple. Dishavatar temple is another example of the temple architecture which was established by, you know, this Guptas. And likewise, we have various other temples which have been established. You know, one temple has been established at Jabalpur as well, and various other places where we can see these features, as I told you, in the Nagara style of temple architecture. Okay? Now see, this was one aspect of the art of the Guptas, temple architecture. Okay, it was temple architecture. Now second feature, second important field of this architecture, art in architecture of the Guptas, was in the form of caves. These caves were already there. These caves were not established by the Guptas. They were improved. These caves were improved upon by the Guptas. Improved by the Guptas by various mural paintings. By various mural paintings. Okay? By various mural paintings, these paintings you can call as frescoes. F-R-E-S-C-O-E-S, frescoes, mural paintings. So the caves which were improved upon by the Guptas during this period, by various decorations, by various paintings, by mural paintings, small paintings. These paintings were made upon the caves from inside. So these mural paintings or the frescoes are sometimes regarded as the best frescoes in the world. And it's because of these reasons that many of these caves, like Ajanta and Ellora, jo main bhi aapko padhane ja raha hun, these are regarded as the world heritage sites in India. World heritage sites. Okay, so the best examples of these mural paintings can be seen from the caves at Ajanta. Okay, then it can be seen at Ellora. These can be seen at Bagh caves as well. Okay, Ajanta, what does it actually mean? Ajanta is a place, as a further information, Ajanta is a place in Aurangabad district of Maharashtra. Okay, wherein there are a group. There are a group of 29 caves. Okay, there are a group of 29 caves. These Ajanta caves are the series of rock cut caves. These are the series of rock cut caves, which are 29 in number, and among 29 caves which are there in Ajanta, there are 9, you know, this 25 are the structures which were known for the which are meant for the residential purposes. Residential purposes. Various monks and various religious persons used to live in these caves at Ajanta. Then four other caves among these 29 messages, four caves thi wahan pe. So they were meant for the prayer purposes. They were meant for the prayers. So residential purposes ko hum bolte this, you can say these were the viharas. Okay, viharas were the caves which were meant for the residential purposes. And you have the four caves which were known as chetiyas, C-H-A-I-T-Y-S. Chetiyas are the caves or the structures which were meant for the prayers. Okay, so these caves were there at the Ajanta, and these caves, Ajanta caves, were constructed from, you know, from they were constructed from 200 BC up to 650 AD. Okay, these Ajanta caves. These Ajanta caves are the series of, you know, this 29 caves. इनका टाइम पीरियड ये है 200 बीसी से लेके 650 एडी पे. आप गुप्ताज को, गुप्ताज ने इन केव्स को इंप्रूव किया बाय एस्टेब्लिशिंग बाय मेकिंग वेरियस ब्यूटीफुल पेंटिंग्स, म्यूरल पेंटिंग्स आर द फ्रेस्कोस फ्रॉम इनसाइड. ओके, सो दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द अजंता केव्स व्हिच इज अ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट इन औरंगाबाद डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. एंड अबाउट दिस अजंता केव्स देयर यू कैन यू नो हैव वन मोर इंफॉर्मेशन. That is, you know, there are some important frescoes, important paintings like the painting number 16. All those paintings have been numbered by the historians, by the archaeologists. Painting number 16 and the painting number 17 is important. Painting number 16, what is known as, you know, this dying princess. Dying princess. And the painting number 17, which is known as the mother and child group. Mother and child group or those kinds of paintings which have received a universal praise because they have been, you know, they have been regarded as the masterpieces as far as the frescoes at Ajanta caves are concerned. Okay, this was the information about the Ajanta caves. Then you have other group of caves which is popularly known as, which is known as Ellora Caves. Ellora Caves is like the Ajanta Caves, it's also in Aurangabad district in Maharashtra. This is also as the World Heritage Site of India. World Heritage Site. World Heritage Site means something which is recognized by UNESCO. You might be knowing because you are preparing for the civil services. World Heritage Site is recognized by UNESCO, you know, UNESCO, United Nations Agency, and there are more than 35 World Heritage Sites in India. Among those, Ajanta and Ellora Caves are also included in the list. Okay, so this Ellora Caves in Aurang, you know, this in Aurangabad district, in Aurangabad district of this Maharashtra, they also constitute an important dimension of the art of Guptas. अब यहाँ पे भी हमें, you know, these are the series of 32 caves. यहाँ पे हमें 32 caves जो है वो मिलते हैं. Among these 32 caves, you know, 16 were dedicated to the Brahmins. 16 were dedicated to the Brahmin priests. Okay, to the Brahmin priests. 12 were, you know, dedicated for the Buddhist monks. 12 were dedicated for the Buddhist monks and 4 were dedicated for, you know, this, the Jain monks. 4 were dedicated for the Jain monks. The time period during which these Ellora caves were constructed, these were constructed from 5th century AD up to 11th century AD. Up to 11th century AD. Okay, so these caves and the paintings which were made inside these caves, they were, you know, they are attributed to the Gupta times. Okay, of course, in addition to Ajanta caves, in addition to Ellora caves, we have the Bagh caves. Bagh caves are in Madhya Pradesh. We have the Nasik caves. We have the Junagadh caves and various other caves which are attributed to the Gupta period. They did one or the other thing which improved their, you know, which improved their style, which improved their structures. So these caves are attributed to the Guptas. So this was all important information about the caves which were established by, which were improved upon by the Guptas. They were already there. They were improved upon by the Guptas by various frescoes. Frescoes are the mural paintings which you need to remember. Now, the art of the Gupta period can also be seen in the form of coins. In the form of coins. As far as the coinage of Gupta time period is concerned, Gupta dynasty is concerned, I told you that they issued the largest number of gold coins in ancient India. They issued the fine gold coins of ancient India, and they bear the images of various rulers and the various kings. As for example, the coins of Chandragupta first. The coins of Chandragupta first. He issued the coins which are known as Chandragupta Kumara Devi type of coins. Chandragupta Kumara Devi. Devi type of coins. He, Chandragupta first, he married with the Kumara Devi, a Lichavi princess, and after their marriage, they issued the fine gold coins which bears the images of both of these, Chandragupta and Kumara Devi on the one side, and on the other side, they bear the images of various Hindu gods and goddesses. Like Durga is shown seated on the loin. This is one, you know, this is one example of, you know, this, the coinage which shows the artistic achievements of the Gupta period. Then Samudragupta, their greatest ruler. Samudragupta is also shown in different poses. Like in one of the coins, he is shown as slaying a tiger. In other coin, he is shown as holding a battle axe. In another coin, he is shown with, you know, wearing a dress, wearing a military dress. You know, in another coin, he's been shown playing a flute, Veena, because of this, because of which he is known as Kaviraj as well. So these artistic features of these Guptas can be seen in their coinage as well. Okay, then there was another field in the form of terracottas, terracotta figures. Terracotta ka matlab hota hai mitti ke bane hue, jo the items which are made up of this soil out of this, which are made up of the soil. तो मिट्टी के बने हुए जो खिलौने वगैरह होते हैं या जो जो भी आइटम्स होते हैं उनको हम टेरिकोटा बोलते हैं. टेरिकोटा फिगर्स, टेरिकोटा फिगर्स ऑफ वेरियस हिंदू गॉड्स एंड गॉडेसेस, वेरियस यू नो यक्षास, यक्षीस एंड वेरियस अदर आइटम्स. दिस यू नो इट वाज एक्चुअली अ पुअर मेन्स आर्ट. इट वाज नॉट पैट्रोनाइज्ड, इट पुअर मेन्स आर्ट. तो यहाँ पे जो लोग थे, गरीब लोग, कॉमन लोग जो होते थे, वो इस टाइप की जो है पॉटरी वगैरह, जो आर्टिफैक्ट्स वगैरह जो है बनाते थे. They were making the items out of this terracotta, out of the soil, which is known as the terracotta figures and figurines, which also comprised an important component of the Gupta art. Alright? Then, you can further see the art and architecture of Gupta period in another one important, you know, this construction which they did. It was in the form of iron pillar. Iron pillar. Okay, iron pillar which is presently placed in Delhi at a place called Mehroli. This iron pillar which is presently there in Delhi near Qutub Minar, if you could have visited there any time, so you will see how, you know, that is presently, that is still shining. That is attributed to Chandragupta II. कहते हैं जो Chandragupta II था, Chandragupta II ने उसको वहां पे बनाया, एंड ही हैज लिस्टेड हिज इंपॉर्टेंट अचीवमेंट्स ऑन दैट आयरन पिलर देयर एट मेहरौली. तो वहां पे इसने लिखा है, यू नो, इन संस्कृत दैट व्हाट आर हिज अचीवमेंट्स. तो दिस आयरन पिलर इंस्क्रिप्शन इतने साल से वहां पे, यू नो, ऑल्दो दैट आयरन पिलर हैज दैट, यू नो, दैट इज देयर विदाउट एनी प्रोटेक्शन, विदाउट एनी रूफ ओवर इट. Okay, so it has not, you know, that iron pillar has not received, you know, little bit of rust at all. Koi rust vast usme, corrosion vagaira nahi laga hai usme. So that speaks about their great artistic, you know, artistic achievement. Then after iron pillar, you know, which was constructed by Chandragupta II, you have the field of sculpture. Sculpture ka bhi thoda dekhiye aap. अगर हम आर्ट पढ़ रहे हैं, जो हम आर्ट पढ़ रहे हैं, स्कल्पचर, एज फार एज द स्कल्पचर इज कंसर्न्ड, दिस स्कल्पचर इज नोन फॉर वन यूनिक फीचर, दैट इज the use of cream colored sandstone. Okay, cream colored sandstone. Cream colored sandstone along with the metal. This was used for, you know, this was used for various artistic activities, and the images which are produced, they bear the distinguished feature. They bear this distinguished art of sculpture. Like we have an example in the form of Sultanganj Buddha. Sultanganj is a place in Bihar. Okay, this Sultanganj Buddha, the beautiful this image of Buddha, you will see therein the best example of the sculpture. This you know, this Sultanganj Buddha, this figure, this image is not there. It has been taken by the Britishers. It is presently lying in the Birmingham Museum, I think. So this Sultanganj, you know, this the image which was actually built at a place in Bihar. You can just click on the internet to see the image. What kind of actually sculpture it was. The Sultanganj Buddha. Then you know this. There are various other examples of this beautiful, you know, this beautiful sculpture which was developed and improved by the Guptas. Then, the aspect of stupa. The stupa, jo hote the, stupas, which is an important Buddhist tradition. The stupas wahan tak develop ho rahe the. The art of stupa, it actually declined under the Guptas. It actually declined under the Guptas, but no doubt one such stupa was there which they established, which they built it. This stupa was at a place called Dhamek. D-H-A-M-E-K-H. Dhamek is a place in Uttar Pradesh. So this Dhamek stupa was built by these Guptas. So you can say that the art of stupa was also seen during the Gupta times. This was all about the important dimensions of the art of the Gupta time period, and you have to remember this thing that it was the great development of the art and architecture which was witnessed during the Gupta time period, and it was under the Guptas that the activities actually, you know, the activities highly developed related to the field of art and architecture. So this is sometimes referred to as the golden period for the ancient Indian architecture, for the first time in Indian history, because of these reasons. Now we will, you know, come to the literature of the Guptas.